So, what I've noticed so far, there is a NERC talking capacitor here. And if most of you are aware of this chip, it's called the NERC talking. It's a capacitor. It's one of the old capacitors. Usually it comes with many faults. Let's have a look. There it is. This is a NERC talking capacitor. It does cause many issues on the board, and I believe it is the main cause here. So now I'm gonna remove this chip and then replace it with four tantalum capacitors. These are tantalum capacitors. It needs to be replaced with four tantalum capacitors with a value of 330 each. Okay guys, now I'm done. We have to make sure that those two pads, they are not touching one another, because the other one is ground and the other one it's a line from the CPU section. So we have to make sure that they are not touching, and check the other two as well, make sure that they are not touching. But first, before we even go far and confirm if they are touching or not, let's start by cleaning those pads. Let's clean those pads. I'm using alcohol to clean the pads. Use the alcohol is the best. To me, they look nice, clean, neat. Yeah, I like what I did here. Let's check this one. I don't really trust this one. As you can see, in between there's a, especially this side, it's not clean, it's not clear. Anyway, I'm done. So what you do, you take your multimeter. Let me switch to my camera mode so that you will see everything clean and clear. All right, this is what you do. You take your multimeter. Okay, there it is. Okay, make sure it's on the continuity mode. Okay, so what we do, we put one probe to ground, and then we check here, no short, and the other one it's ground, no short. All right, and then after this, what do you do? You take your tantalum capacitor. You know how to connect them, right? One to ground, and the other side to positive. Ground, positive. Okay, let's put them. You put two per line. Two per line. like this. Okay, let me do it under the microscope. I want to show you everything step by step. This is how you change the neck talking capacitor. This is how you replace it. Okay, you put one like this, and then you put the second one as well, exactly like this. But the best way to do it, you have to put one and then check if they are touching or not. Okay guys, after putting these two, we have to check for a shot before we even proceed. Let's see if they are not touching. Okay. As you can see, there is no shot at all. So it means we did a good job. And the other side, obvious, there will be a shot, but this side here, there is no shot at all. All right, this is perfect. Let's continue. Now let's put the second one's on the other side, these two here. One like this. Put another one. All right, this is perfect. Let's go ahead. Thank you. Okay, guys, let's go ahead. Let's check for shorts. But anyway, this is how you do it. This is how you replace the neck token capacitor with four tertium with four tertium capacitors with a value of 380 each. This is how you do it. Okay, turn on your multimeter. Make sure it's under continuity mode. Then you touch. Getting a value of 114. This is ground, obvious, and this is positive 114. I mean 144, 144, 145 on the other side. But it's same thing. 145, as you can see, it's same thing. Let me show it to you one more time under the microscope, so that you will have a clean and clear understanding on how you replace the neck token with tantalum capacitors. It's very, very, very simple, guys. I won't lie to you, it's very, very easy. See the other one as well. Anyway, let's discuss some few things. Why do we replace a neck token capacitor? This is one of the old tech or old components that they were using before in most of old laptops. This was a very, 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 very bad capacitor. So as you can see, nowadays they replace the, you see, this is a CPU, right? The bottom part, you'll always see capacitors, four of them, five of them, or three of them. Okay, but on these models, they were using a neck token capacitor. It fails like now and then, and once it's failed, sometimes your PC will turn on display but stuck on a logo, or maybe go to Windows or trash like now and then, or sometimes the PC, it won't even turn on at all. There will be like several issues. As long as you have the neck token, you will have different issues. You have to remove the neck token. It is one of the bad and old failed component that was used a long time ago. Please guys, if you see a neck token, if you are repairing a laptop with a neck token, please go ahead, don't waste time, just remove the neck token, even if it's not the cause of the problem. But please believe me, that thing will fail anytime soon. Just remove that capacitor and put four tantalum capacitors with a value of 380 each. Anyway, thank you so much, guys. Shab shab.